Alright guys, for this video we're going to be comparing the two Vivitar Action cams that I have right now. So this one is a 14 megapixel action camera. This is a 12 megapixel action camera. Both of them can shoot in 1080p. So those are basically the specs. Now as far as the features that each of these have, I will be doing just like showing what's on each side. So going to the little ports on the side here, if you can see that, we have an HDMI cable port, or probably many, many HDMI port. Then we have the micro USB port. Then we have actually a microphone port on here. I don't know if you can see that little circle right there next to the mini HDMI port, but it has a microphone port for that. And then a memory card slot. So here on this one, it's a little bit more concealed, more along the lines of waterproofing. If I can get it open. Okay, so it's like a little flap here. And if you can see that, we have a mini HDMI port, a micro SD card, memory card slot, and then also a micro USB port. But I don't know if there is a port for a microphone, so that may be like a drawback for this if you're actually looking to have a microphone connected to this. So that's the ports that's on it. A plus that is concealed, because that's a plus when it's like raining outside, or just so the ports won't get wet. On this one is more exposed, so that's for me a downside. So going on to the little buttons here, we have on this one, we have a menu button. And then we also have a Wi-Fi button. On this side, we also have a power on button. If you hold it and press it, then it powers on. Then it also has this Wi-Fi button down here. Let me make sure that's correct. I know it's kind of hard to see. That's why I'm trying to point it up towards the light. But yeah, a Wi-Fi button here. And then here we have the little clip, or the little slide that you can take off the back and remove the battery. So that's all that's on that side. And everything seems to be on the reverse side. Like if you look at it, the lenses are facing the same way, but it's pretty much the opposite of each other. So yeah, but that's the little menu buttons there. And then the top is probably the similar things, but on this one we have the little OK button. Then on the other side we have the power button, which we turn it on with. And then on this one we have a little button, the shutter button. Basically you press that to record. This has the microphone on the top, as far as I know. And then on the other side, we have a screen to let you know how much time you have to record, what setting is on. Though, if I turn it on, right? If I turn it on, it's pretty small. Even though this is a bad camera, you can tell that the only thing you can really see is the amount of time you can record with. You don't really know what mode is on, whether it be 720 or 1080. That's hopefully that you can guys can see that. So that's as close as I can get. This camera is pretty crappy, as someone had let me know. But for this, we'll go into that a little bit. But yeah, that is the top of the cameras. And as you know, the lenses This is a wide angle lens for the 12 megapixel here. And then this, I don't know if this is wide angle, but I know it's smaller. And when I record in 1080p, which you'll see in the ending of this video, it doesn't seem to be like that fisheye type lens. But moving on to the back. On the back of this one, we have a removable back where we can take out the battery and all that stuff, right? And then on the back here, we have a screen, which you can probably see. I don't know how this got like the screen got like this, but it does work. Yeah, it does work. It just, for some reason, it was getting like really hot and the plastic on the screen just bubbled up. But I didn't know. You can press the power button to switch modes. Not sure if that's coming up. Well, I know for a fact it's not coming up, so. But you hold the power button to cut that off. But yeah, the screen, like you can probably see that now, but it just like bubbled up for some reason. So unfortunately, that's like that, and I just got it not too long ago. So, but yeah, so that's the back. I want to show, like on the side here, you have the little part where you pull it up, and then you actually have to pull this up and then push this out like that. And that's the removable battery. Let me turn this off before I remove the battery. But yeah, that's basically the battery. So that's the battery right there for the 12 megapixel camera. And I'll put that back in just so it won't be that much of a problem. And then the back seems to be like a aluminum type back. But yeah, that's the back. And then moving on to the bottom, which is the last but not least of the features. So on the bottom of here, on the bottom of the 14 megapixel, we actually have the battery port here. If I can actually get it open. Bam. Then on the inside, you have the battery for this little plastic tab to actually take it out. So if I pull that out, that is the battery. So a little bit smaller, but a little bit more bulk to it. So put that back in and close it up. But that is the bottom of it. That's where the battery goes. And as you can see, it has like a little design to it if you look at it close enough. Yeah, it has like a little stripe design, but that's where the battery is. That's the bottom of that one. Here, on the bottom of here, we actually have a tripod screw mount right here, which I do highly enjoy. I am very, very unsatisfied with the fact that for this camera, you actually have to actually have a mount to mount it to a tripod or whatever you want to mount it to. So here we have the tripod screw mount, and then on the bottom we have the battery pack. So that is basically the physical features of these cameras. Now, which one I enjoy physically, I would say mainly this one, mainly because it has the screen on the back so I can see what I'm actually shooting. And I'll get into the app, which both of these have the app for it, and it's the same app basically. But as far as the physical features. I enjoyed this one a little bit better, mainly because it's sleek. It has a sleek design, has a screen on the back which you can, like, you know, see what you're shooting, so that way you won't have to test it as much as this one, because I usually have to shoot and then check the video, shoot and check, make sure I have the correct view for this one. But for this one, I know exactly what I'm shooting, and also the menu on it is pretty sleek, like the menu. And also you can view the videos that you shoot on this camera through the viewfinder. So I'll probably try and get some video of that, but otherwise that's the physical features. Hands down, this one is my better choice as far as the physical features. Unfortunately, the screen has taken a beating even while having it not even a 2 weeks. So but as far as the app, the app for each of these cameras, now I got this one first. I got this one like probably 5 months ago, and I'm not sure if I just got a one with a bad Wi-Fi chip in it or whatever. But for this, when using the app, I have a lot of connectivity troubles with this camera. It does not seem to connect properly, and it always, the app always crashes. The, you know, when I usually, you turn it on and then you turn the Wi-Fi button on, you connect it, connect your phone to it through the Wi-Fi, you know, start up the app, then you click on that one of the little tabs, and it'll pretty much bring up what the camera is viewing. Now with this one, I tried multiple times to do this, and I always had trouble doing that, because every time I click on the app, on the tab in the app, the camera will shut off, and then I have to turn back on the camera, reconnect through the Wi-Fi, try it again. Camera would cut off, app would crash. Recently they have updated the app, so maybe it was just app troubles or whatever, but all in all, my experience with the app as far as this camera was not that great. So moving on to the 14 megapixel camera, for this one, first time I ever tried, and I was kind of skeptical about the app as far as this one, because I was like, okay, well, you know, since I'm having trouble with this one, then it might be the same for this one. Maybe it's just the app or whatever. But even before updating the app, connected to the app with this camera, and as soon as I installed the, when I installed the app, but pretty much as soon as I connected my phone to the Wi-Fi or through the camera's Wi-Fi or whatever, started up the app, installed the, or made sure it was registered in the app as one of my cameras, clicked on the button, started loading, started up, no problems at all, none whatsoever. Every single time I connect to the app, no problem at all. With this one, it's just still the same problem. So maybe I just got one, a camera with the with a bad Wi-Fi chip in, or a bad connectivity chip, or whatever you want to call it. So, but yeah, that is as far as the app. Hands down, this one wins, mainly because no connectivity troubles. I also do have a couple of videos that I will put in between before I go to the next segment to kind of show you like where I'm using my phone to actually control the camera. And I was at work and all that stuff. For some reason, I forgot to take it off slow motion, so that will show too. As far as the software I have not tried for either of the cameras. I know for a fact that here I have one of them, one of the CDs. This one I put in today, and this one is for the 12 megapixel camera, which I had got first, and you'll see that you'll see this CD in the unboxing of this camera here. But put it in today, and I know I just said I didn't try, but to correct myself, I did try this one. The other one I did not try yet. But I tried put this in, and I went to install the app or install the computer application, as I would think. And it turns out you need to be connected to the internet to actually install this, which is pretty stupid, because if you're installing an application for PC, why would you need the internet to actually install the app? So that's my whole thing. So that's pretty crappy. That is the software portion. Like I said, I haven't tried the software CD for the 14 megapixel camera. So that's basically what it is. Let's see, what else? As far as the, I don't want to dive too much into the video and audio portion, mainly because you'll see after this portion of the video, you'll see both audio and visual video for each of these cameras, and I will label which videos which, all that stuff. So we'll do this. Basically, I'll just kind of give my opinion on the audio and video, and then we'll move into that segment of the audio video for the example. But as far as the video, as far as 1080p, now I'm only rating the 1080p because I only recorded in 1080p for both of these cameras, and I've only recorded in 1080p with this camera, period, since I got it. So only rating 1080p setting. For the 14 megapixel camera, I found that it was too zoomed to actually, you know, be worth shooting, unless it's, you know, unless you're shooting with a stationary view. You know, movement with the 1080p is just not, it's not gonna work. Like, even if you watch the bowling footage that I got, which came out yesterday, you will see that the first game that I recorded, it was just too zoomed to even see anything. Like, me moving my head just an inch is like equivalent to moving my head just like 15 degrees or something like that. And I mean, that makes no sense, but at the same time, if you watch the video, you'll understand what I'm saying. It's like, you know, it's moving too much, or it's moving too far to be able to even see what I'm trying to record. So, you know, it's just not at all to my liking. I mean, if I'm forced to shoot in 720, you know, I haven't even tried 720 on this camera. Hopefully, you know, it's a little bit better. But then again, if you have a wider view on the 720 as opposed to the 1080, you know, that's what, you know, why would you even do that? Even 1080p should be beautiful, just like having that wide angle view. At first, when I first started using the 12 megapixel camera, this one with no screen, I found when I first started using it, it was too wide for me. I don't know if that's like weird, but it was too wide for me, and I was like, okay, well, you know, I wish it was a little bit smaller, or like a little bit more condensed. But I grew on the wide angle view, and since I started, like, and how I grew on to it is the bowling portion. Like, when I did the first person bowling videos, this video camera, this action camera, captured everything. I mean, it recorded, like, I don't know how many lanes, just standing there and just like recording from just the edge of the lane, just looking towards the pins in the back. You can see a crazy amount of lanes. You can see the crazy amount of, like, just plainly everything, basically. It was like, it captured everything. And even in the bowling footage that I uploaded yesterday, you'll see that it's like a little bit different. It's like, even if I like move my head, it doesn't matter with this camera because it's gonna capture everything. And that's what I love about that. The video, like I've always said, is amazing on this camera. As long as the lens is clean now. It's just amazing. Like, man, I love it. Love it, love it. As far as the audio for these cameras, I haven't really tested the audio side by side, so I can't really gauge. What it's gonna be like when I put them together, and just like, you'll hear one after the other, and you'll hear the difference as far as like the cameras, mainly because they're side by side, instead of like in one video you see this, or in one portion of it in a video you see this, and then it skips some time frame, and then you'll hear the other portion. You know, it's a little bit different when it's side by side. So, but the audio, as far as the 12 megapixel camera, I don't know, it sounds a little bit tinny, if you get what I mean. It sounds like it's in a tin can, where like you'll hear a humming noise, like a humming, like if you kind of get like, if you've watched back one of my Final Fantasy 15 videos, I had recently, like, I had my mic on one side of the desk, then I had my PlayStation 4 on the other side of the desk, and as we all know, the PlayStation 4, it hums, and it, you know, you hear the fans in it. The mic was picking up those fans, so in the background of the video, you can hear, like, those fans running, and it's just, like, constant. It's kind of sort of like that with this, where even if you're just having the camera sit there, you'll hear like some type of humming noise. Even if it's quiet around you, you'll hear that humming noise. And it's like, it just sets me off. Like, I want clear audio, but at the same time, the video, you know, you gotta sacrifice something for another thing. So I think what this camera does is it sacrifices the audio for the video. And then as far as this one, it sounds better to me. I don't know why, but the audio sounds more clear, and you don't really hear that little humming noise in the back as you usually do. So I'm guessing for 1080p, it sacrifices the video portion for the audio. So that's a little bit, it's like, what would you rather have, video as opposed to audio, or audio as opposed to video, you know? So I think that's what that, you know, does for both of the cameras. But that is, I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I need to think about. You know, I've explained the menu portion, even with the screens, different screen sizes. Of course, if it's bigger, then it's gonna be, you know, a little bit better. I think that's about it as far as the features, physical features, and then the video versus audio and all that stuff. On another note, not sure if you can tell, but it seems like this camera is a little bit thicker than this one. But this one is a little bit more taller. This one is taller. So, not sure. But, hey. So, yeah, that's about it. We're going to get on into the video audio portion. I'll put that in, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Maybe I'll add something at the end of that, but if, you know, if I don't forget to be brilliant. Stay inspired. You know what it is. Yes, you know what it is. Peace. All right, guys, so this is a video comparison, video audio comparison of the two cameras. Both are
action camera. In my left hand, I have the 14 megapixel Vivitar action camera, Wi-Fi. In my right hand, I have the 12 megapixel action camera. Both are recording in 1080p. Not sure where the microphones are on the 14 megapixel camera, but I know that the one on the top for the one is on the top for the 12 megapixel camera. But this is just a video audio comparison. Both, like I said, both are recorded in 1080p. And yeah, so I know I had this 12 megapixel camera for about 5 months. Now that video comparison will be, or that review is coming out later. Let's go ahead and get a grass shot like last time. Make sure we get all that. Not sure how well they're doing. I know the 14 megapixel camera has like a screen on it. Not sure if you can see it because of the sun, but yeah. But the 12 megapixel camera does not. So, but let's go ahead and get a sun shot also. I know the Samsung Galaxy Note 4 had a, I think a automatic white balance or something like that. So when it, you know, when it's viewing a lot of light going into the camera, it'll adjust the brightness or it adjusts the white balance on there automatically, so that way you'll be able to see what is going on the video. So yeah, that's basically about it for the video comparison. I actually had to record this twice because my camera was actually recording in slow motion, the 14 megapixel camera. So yeah, that is about it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video comparison, video audio comparison. And yeah, that is it, basically. Peace.